What is up, everyone? It's Silver here, and today I actually have something that's was kind of unexpected, though
Hi everyone, I'm
slightly
Ash, the
expected.
McCoy from the
What you're
Treehouse.
seeing right
Hope
now
you
on your
enjoy.
screen is a
Yeah, it's
video
nice to
that
be home
Nintendo
for
released
the
earlier this morning. I was
2015
actually
Winter
awake
Olympic
when this
Games
went
in Tokyo,
live,
and
which
I've
was
got
around
Treehouse
like
teams from
6 in the morning.
Europe, Australia, Canada,
But they decided
all
to
coming
upload
to
a
watch the
video talking
2020
about
Olympic
the
Games.
Splatoon tournament that's going to
Sony's
be happening
obviously
at
a good
E3.
opportunity. Can you
And
take a
in the
moment
video, they
and
decided to go
detail
over
out
the
the
ranked
Treehouse
modes, as
Splatoon
it was
Olympic Games
recently revealed
as
that
well
the
as
tournament
highlight
will
some
contain
gameplay
the
from one of
ranked
the players
modes,
who
when it was originally
enjoyed the
thought that it
games
was
but
just going to be
maybe
Turf
are
War
still
all the way
taking that
through.
step into
And
the
I'm not going to
future.
talk too much about
And when you
that
look at some of the
tournament,
greats
as
that have been
it's not
enshrined in
really
history due
too
to their
relevant,
time at the
though
World
I am going to
Championships,
say that it's very dumb how
so enjoying what you
they
are
decided
now
they're
is
going to do
probably
round
the
robin
best
for four
commentary you can
teams.
get. But
But
it's
so they
really
get we get
a
this
slow move
short
forward,
like
so
6 minute
a
video
boot camp
where
kind of
they
format
spend the
for
first part of this kind of
Splatoon 2,
just
where
discussing
you catch
the
until one
game and how
match
they
and then
got the
knock out the other.
commentators.
First off,
Basically, they're saying that the
how the story
commentators
mechanics are sort of
this is
laid
like their
out from
first time ever
a
being
tech
exposed to the game,
that you really put
which
into the
concerns me
game,
slightly that
and
people that are supposed to be
being
commentating this
hands-on with
tournament
Splatoon 2,
have very
you'll
little
find out that
knowledge
balance
about
is
the
paramount
game to
to
begin
depth
with,
or even control.
but it's
So you
fine.
really get into
So
Splatoon
we
2
get to
with
see
Splatoon
some
3 and
footage
obviously
of
some
the
Splatoon
what I'm
4
going to assume is that new
before you
stage
get
or the
taking that core
can't even
playing
remember the name of it, but it's
from
the
territory to
concert
ship,
stage
then apply
level.
it to
That's
your
going to be very
opponent's
common.
ship.
I don't
And then
remember
very
names, but
important
we
is
get a
that
nice little
you
overhead
pick
view
up
through the
successful
spectator mode in
maps
the
that you're
game.
trying to cover
They're going to
throughout,
continue to
but you
ramble on
really
about it. I'm not
need to
listening to it
maintain
right now because I
that
have it muted,
winning
but you
streak
guys will be
through
hearing the
the whole
nonsense that they're
organization.
saying.
And once you can check off
But
that box
so this
of
whole video
map
is,
control,
I
you're
guess at this point,
then
as there really isn't too
locked
much
on to hitting on the
importance. We
talent
get to see
grabbing the reins of
a
things.
very
And when you do that,
quick
you then take
glance
control
over
of the
at
map
the
and then
ranked
number one
modes here.
regain control of the
And
map.
this is what this
Number
I'm going to
two
be talking about
gain
today, and it
control.
is
And
my
then
thoughts
finally
on
gain
these ranked
control to
modes
attack the
from
objective
this
right
video
away.
and how
And
they
really use
compare
that
to the first
foundation
game's
for your
versions
control
of the ranked
whenever
modes.
Splatoon starts in Splatoon
So
3. I've
when they
felt really
finally
stuck
get to
for
that
Splatoon
point,
2 and Splatoon
I'm
3,
trying to
and
watch,
I
have this
saw
go play in
that there
full
were
for those that might
still
have not
just
seen
new
it.
areas to
So
learn
I
and
apologize if
improve,
there really isn't too much for me to talk about while I'm
but
waiting
they were
for them
also
to
like
get to
finding
the point
themselves out. So
to
they
where
were
I
worried
can
about
actually
getting back
discuss what
before
is
the
happening here.
considering where
So
my
we'll have to
post
wait a
stops for
second
and how to
here.
secure the
The objective,
objective.
it's
What's
what's
my
my
positioning
positioning
that'll
that'll
be
be
safe
safe
so
so
I
I
don't
don't
end
end
up
up
getting
getting
splatted
splatted
and
and
turn
turn
into
into
this
this
further
further
liability
liability
to
to
my
my
team
team
because
because
I'm
I'm
at
at
the
the
spawn
spawn
point
point
and
and
not
not
in
in
the
the
mix?
mix?
But
But
also,
also,
if
if
things
things
go
go
wrong,
wrong,
how
how
can
can
I
I
get
get
out
out
quickly?
quickly?
Yeah,
Yeah,
it's
it's
really
really
interesting
interesting
when
when
you
you
watch
watch
these
these
elite
elite
players
players
and
and
you
you
get
get
some
some
feedback
feedback
before
before
any
any
of
of
the
the
players
players
are
are
in
in
the
the
game
game
and
and
you
you
know
know
how
how
to
to
play
play
the
What's
game
interesting
and
is in
you
this,
know
they
how to
actually
play the
talk
game
about
and you know
the
how to
people
play
they
the game
watched
from
in
a
the US
competitive
Open,
territory where
and for
you
those
know
they
you
were
can
unaware, I
survive
actually,
and
with my
excel
team,
in
we
Splatoon 2.
participated in
Which is why did you become
the
so
event
excited
or
about
the
Splatoon
tournament that
2
would get
that
you
you
to
wanted to
E3.
see it
Unfortunately, we didn't
perform
win. We ended up coming in
at E3
fifth
and
place out of
really make it
140
what you
teams,
really
so we're
wanted to
happy
be.
to have gotten that far in it.
And so making sure
So
that you can stay alive and be able to help your team comes down to, again, territory control.
Yeah, it's huge. It's huge. And it's really one of those things. I think, Corey, we've talked about it quite a bit, but like, I don't know of any other, a whole lot of other games where like painting the area around you, that
Right.
territory control mechanic really facilitates how you can travel and, you know, and hindering your opponent's ability to travel as well. It's really sort of unique to the game.
Yeah, I think it's made the game, certainly in the community, a little more accessible as well because
Mm-hmm.
you don't, you know, it's not a game that you just have to be shooting, you know, for headshots and killing
Right.
your opponents, right? You can be contributing just as much to your team just by creating that the territory.
So one of the new differences is in Splats.
All right, they're finally getting to the point where they're talking about the ranked modes. The first one they're going to talk about is Splat Zones, which didn't really see too big of a change in Splatoon 2, which was kind of expected. I didn't really see them changing too much about it because there really wasn't too much you could change about Splat Zones while keeping the ideas simple. Now there's a new indicator on the HUD that replaced the icon that showed who had the zone. Now it shows how many points are, you know, in the zone. So it shows who has more control over the zone than the other player, which is more valuable than just knowing who has the zone and who doesn't, or if it's neutral. Now with the tower control, they've shown off that the now the tower has checkpoints, parts in the map where the tower will stall for a set period of time before moving again. I kind of like this because then it just basically makes it so you have to stand still, and it just kind of tests whether or not you have the you're really defending it. So if you get to a checkpoint and then you all die and you like you're not effectively protecting the tower, then you're going to lose control of it. I kind of like it, though it seems very arbitrary. And the one thing I'm curious about is, will you have to redo the checkpoints as you're going through them again? Or will once you clear a checkpoint, that's that, you won't have to deal with it ever again?
It's so intense at times, but there's also a small tweak to that as well.
Yeah, so of course the goal...
Now they're going to be getting to the change to Rainmaker. This is pretty interesting, as this the Rainmaker now fires a ball that explodes and creates like a burst shot. This replaces the tornado that the Rainmaker originally created, and I could see why they changed this completely. Like, the Rainmaker probably has one of the more jank hitboxes in the game. It's very weird, and you could get hit around corners or above walls, below walls. Really weird angles you could get killed at from the Rainmaker. And so I guess they decided to change it to avoid having that kind of problem. And the new Rainmaker, I think, is a lot better. And it seems less like a just fire in this direction and get kills. You do have to kind of aim it. There is that burst at the end, which probably will do a lot of splash damage to people nearby it, but it still requires you to aim instead of just firing in a direction and basically just destroying anyone that was in the way. Now, that is the end of the actual video itself. However, there is something that I want to talk about specifically from that video, and it is a screenshot. Yeah, you might have seen it. It popped up for a little bit in the video. But there was a point where the person in the video got killed, and we could see the abilities and the gear for the player that killed him. And in this, we can see a few interesting things. First off, the headgear, the main ability on the headgear, is something different. It's not an icon we've seen before. It is the kind of squid you would expect from, like, Quick Respawn, except it's pink with a blue timer next to it. I personally think this might seem like a tenacity change, like a different tenacity icon. I'm not too sure. It is on headgear, which tenacity did exist on solely, which is why I think it's tenacity. And then we can see for the shoes, the main ability has the Ink Saver sub icon, but it also has the defense icon on it. And I thought about this while I was at work this morning, and I thought maybe this means that damage up and defense up have been split. So instead of damage up and defense up affecting everything, maybe now there is main defense and main damage up and sub damage up and sub defense up. So you will have to wear a specific ability to make your gun stronger or your sub weapon stronger, or the thing to make other people's sub weapons or main weapons weaker and sub weapons weaker. And that would kind of split, you know, the damage up and defense up from being two abilities to being four. And that might be what this is, so I'm just going to call this sub-defense. And then we can also see that the QR, or the double quick respawn squid icon, whatever, is in fact a sub-ability. There was, in a previous video of mine, I mentioned that it's very likely that it becomes a main exclusive ability, and that it just acts as if two mains of QR from the first game. Well, that's proven wrong, and now it looks like it is, in fact, a sub-ability. However, we still don't know if it's just normal quick respawn or the double squids actually mean anything. One really big thing here is the ink resistance icon. It's a sub-ability. It is not shown as a main ability, which it exists in Splatoon 1 as a main exclusive ability. It was only available on shoes, but here we can see it as a sub on his shirt. So now begs the question, what does ink resistance do now? Is it unchanged, but now you have to like stack a bunch of it to get that effect? This is kind of curious because throughout the test fire, me and quite a few other people felt that you kind of needed ink resistance in this one. You kind of got punished quite a bit from being an enemy ink. And I'm not sure if it just makes it, like, the visuals make it more apparent that you are taking damage, or you were just taking more damage. As it, like, from just stepping in enemy ink, almost your entire screen gets covered in their ink, making it feel like you've taken a lot more damage than you have. So I'm not sure if that's just a visual thing, or you were in fact taking a lot more damage compared to the first game without ink resistance. And if making it a sub and a main ability, then I could definitely see people putting on a decent amount of ink resistance. And then there's another screenshot. This was tweeted This wasn't any of the videos. They showed off Moray Towers again, and we can see here that the zones in Moray Towers have actually been moved to the middle of the map. And I don't know how I feel about this. The zones in Moray were always pretty bad, but from other screenshots we've seen, they made the areas where the zones were a bit bigger. But now, they've made those bigger, but they've put it in the middle area, which kind of looks bigger, but now it's still a double zone map on a small area that may or may not have actually been expanded, instead of keeping in the area they did expand. This I'm not exactly sure how I feel about. I'd have to actually play it, but I've seen some people in Discord saying that now it looks like all a Dynamo would have to do is flick from the snipe to cover both zones, and that would make Dynamo an actual thing on Moray, where normally it would just be fodder for a charger. So we'll have to see what more information comes out. We're definitely going to be seeing probably all the maps at the tournament that happens at E3. I'll probably do a video on that after it happens, because we're probably going to get a bit more information from E3. And I'm hoping that they announce another test fire, because the first Splatoon got 3 of them prior to release, and so far we've only got 1. So I'd like to see a different test fire. What are your guys' thoughts on the changes to the ranked modes, and do you think there will be any more, or will this be the only 3 ranked modes that appear in Splatoon 2? I want to thank everyone for watching, and I will see you all later.